Welcome to the panel today. We are talking about marketing and book promo in the middle of a pandemic. And we have an awesome panel here today. My name is Lisa Daly. I will be moderating today. First, say hi. We have Vincent Zandri. He is the New York Times ITW Thriller Award-winning author of more than 40 novels. That blows me away. I don't even know how you do that. And novellas, including The Remains, the Chase Baker thriller series, and the forthcoming The Girl Who Wasn't There.
Hi. Hello. Looking forward to this one. Hope everybody's surviving the pandemic.
Definitely, definitely. So we also have Doug Lyle, D.P. Lyle, with us today. He is the Amazon number one best-selling, McCavity and Benjamin Franklin award-winning, Edgar Agatha Anthony Seamus Scribe, and USA Best Book Award nominated author of 20 books, including the Jake Longley and the Kane Harper thriller series. Say hi, D.P. Lyle.
Glad to be here. Thanks.
Thanks so much. All right, we also have Joe Clifford here today. Joe is the author of the Jay Porter thriller series, as well as several other books. And I find this hilarious, Joe, you did not put this on your bio that you sent to me. Joe is actually a nominee this year for the ITW Thriller Award for hardcover. So, So we also have Matt Coyle with us here today. Matt, say hi.
Hello.
For those of you who don't know, Matt is the author of the best-selling Rick Cahill crime series, the latest of which, Lost Tomorrows, recently won the Lefty for the best mystery novel. Super, super exciting. We also have Mary Jones with us today. Mary is a suspense and thriller writer who has published 21 books and is the author of Child's Play, among many, many others. And we have Drew Murray with us today, who is a debut novelist. His brand new book, Broken Genius, is coming out Tuesday. Whew, wow. That's pretty exciting. Which is already passed by the time you guys see this, but it's coming out. It's already out. It's great. It's fantastic. All right. So you guys, this is like such a huge topic right now, because I think a lot of authors are freaking out about books they have coming out. I know a lot of you have books coming out. And what are you doing right now to market your book during the pandemic? How has it changed things? Mary, I'm going to go to you first. How are you changing things?
Well, for one thing, you can't do bookstores because they're not open. And so you end up, at least I'm ending up doing Zooms, a lot of group things with other writers. But you know, I just don't get it how people are supposed to market anything during this time. It just seems like everything is virtual, and it's very hard to connect with readers, especially I would think with a new book to launch. I know people who've launched books just virtually, and it's been less than satisfying for the people that I've spoken to. You know, they're used to getting a couple hundred people and they may get 40 on the online.
Don't make Drew cry, because his book is coming out. He's also our
tech guy. Drew is going to be different. Or Drew isn't going to be like those. But it's really been hard, especially when you're having trouble motivating yourself. Not everybody does, but I think during the pandemic, I've had trouble motivating myself because the structure around me and the context that I normally have, I'm not having anymore. So it's hard to keep that momentum up, at least for some of us.
Yeah, definitely. Vincent, how are you feeling about that?
For me, it hasn't been... I haven't really changed my strategies all that much, because I don't do a whole lot of signings anyway. I usually do like one a year, usually at the mystery, or, you know, at Otto's, at the mystery bookshop down in New York, and that's about it. So I rely on my newsletter, you know, however many thousand subscribers I've got, and I'm constantly working with BookFunnel to increase that. I do a lot of giveaways. I have like, I'm friends with a ton of my subscribers, or I've gotten to be friends, and like, so they've come to rely on me to put out a newsletter, not just once a month, but I bet you I put it out 2 or 3 times a week.
Oh, wow.
It goes against the grain, which I know that goes against the grain big time. And I've been relying on social media for 10 years, but what I did differently now is I started a Facebook live show called Hot Topics. And I try to do something at least maybe 5 times a week. I mean, it's brand new. And I also find what's been effective is to use your Facebook, Your Story.
Uh-huh.
And I haven't even started on Instagram's Your Story yet, but I'm going to. And a lot of promo sites, I use those. So I've been working this way for a long time. I'll do articles on Medium. I'll write for my own blog, things like that. So I've The Girl Wasn't There will be released on the ebook will be released on the 30th. And for me, I think it'll be sort of like business as usual.
Okay.
And in October, hopefully the bookstores will be back open, ready and, willing to do a signing or two there, maybe a launch party.
All right, fantastic. Okay, so Matt, you are like the king of the bookstore schmooze. I just feel like you are so connected to so many bookstores. And so how do you think you would change? I know how would you change now?
Well, fortunately or unfortunately, my last book came out in December. So I got most of my bookstores done. There's always a few things fell out. Things always pop up throughout the year for every author, and then those have fallen out. But I don't know what I would do during this. I'd obviously be on social media as much as possible, and Facebook Live, I think I would get into that. I'm thinking of doing that anyway, but this is a horror. Well, sorry, Drew. I know Doug's book just came out, and I'm curious to know what I've seen some posts from him, but I'm curious to know what Doug's been doing, because he's had to live this real time.
Yeah, this is Doug is like was my next stop, right? Because he has a book coming out right now, right? So tell us, what are you doing? Because you really are just a tireless self-promoter. I mean, you are so, so good.
Well, I agree with kind of what Drew said. I don't think things have changed. If you go back through the last 2 decades, and particularly the last decade, look at how things have morphed. Doing book tours and going to bookstores is a dwindling commodity. Number one, bookstores are dying. Borders is gone, which was the best. Barnes and Noble, they don't really do a good job for the most part. They used to, but now they're got their own issues. We got our independent bookstores who we love. There's 3 of them around here in San Diego and Orange County that I support and go to. Actually, at Mystery Inc., Debbie Mitch's place in Huntington Beach, I actually had a live in-person launch party. We set up a canopy in the parking lot and had it out there. And it was actually fun. But, it was sparsely attended because people are afraid to get out and all that. But if you look at things have evolved to the digital world, I think people read more digital books now. Mm-hmm. Like it or not, but the mass market paperback died because of ebooks. And now we've got, trade paperback and hardback. Most people read electronic books now. And so they're going to order them electronic. And that's sad for the bookstores, but we've been moving in the last decade toward digital marketing anyway. And we've been, the Facebook and the Twitter and LinkedIn and having your own podcast and your own blog and your own website and all those things were always important, but they're on the upswing where live appearances seem to be waning. And I think that's sad. I'm like Matt. I like to go see people, talk to people and laugh and cut up and all that stuff. But I'm afraid that that is dwindling. And it's sad, but the e-market's going up. So you got to do it digitally. That's it. I don't think things have changed because of this. I think they were changing anyway.
It was going that direction anyway. Joe Clifford, I'm going to come to you last, Drew, because you are like the king of Silicon Valley. So Joe, what do you think? Because you do a ton of book marketing, but you do a lot of online stuff and a lot of stuff. So how are things changing for you right now?
I'm still trying to get over Mary Saint. She had 200 people come to a book launch. People that had to beg them to come. Please come. I stopped doing book launches because they're just like Matt saying. It's just getting harder and harder. I spend more time online arguing with internet, strangers on the internet about politics. Trying to just in any way making myself visible. I've always kind of done this like side approach where, I'm talking about my kids, I'm talking about my life, I'm talking about my books, so that I'm just basically visible and active and they see my name. I think what happens is the more they see your name, and, I saw Doug, you did your launch the other day, and I tuned in because, it was live and I know Doug, and it was the right time. And I was sitting at my computer at the right time. I sat down, I listened to you, answer some questions. I think that's so much of what happens on social media. It's timing. It's if you're there, like, okay, well, it's 7 o'clock, I'll tune in. So I'm just always trying to have something going. I did, a Q&A with my Italian publisher the other day. I do these Zooms. Mostly I just write. I mean, I've been writing an awful lot. I got a lot of books coming out. I got one coming out every 6 months for like the next few years, which is great. But a lot of my time is writing and trying to interact with people and fans and friends and keep your name out there, because once you disappear for a few days, nobody misses you. Nobody knows where you're going. Like, they just don't care. Like, not because they don't care, but because, out of sight, out of mind. And that's sort of what we're working with now in the digital age. You have to like constantly be presenting yourself any way you can do that. Whether it's try to avoid politics, but talking politics, talking current events or anything, that your name is there and they see your name, you're somebody, and then you go somewhere, they're like, oh yeah, I know you, you're the guy who's online all the time, which helps. I mean, it helps sell books.
I haven't missed you at all.
I miss you, Joe. All right, so Drew has his debut novel coming out, but you also are like, super plugged in to the whole online world. So what are you doing with it? Because I'm watching your book launch happening in real time, and I'm really excited about some of the things that you're doing. So talk about that. What are you doing right now?
I am doing a lot of things right now. It's incredibly busy. Like you say, I'm a really tech person. I worked in tech for 20 years. I'm very much a digital citizen. So this is, my book launch was 95% digital, 5% in-person signings anyway. And once the pandemic started, we just converted the last 5% to virtual, and everything's been virtual. so I've been writing articles for blogs. I wrote an article for the National Post, the national newspaper here in Canada. And interestingly, they didn't even print it in the print edition, because they only print a fraction of their content on the actual physical print paper. The rest of it's all online anyway. So I wrote an article for them about cybersecurity during COVID-19. And then I've been doing podcasts. Another aspect of the book that I wrote is that it takes place at a Comic-Con. So you know what? Like, everybody who's into Comic-Cons, everybody who's into that space, they're all virtual anyway. They're all online. So there were a number of podcasts that I could tap into and be interviewed for and reach people that way. And of course, social media. I've been active on Twitter and Instagram and Facebook. And I'm also a college professor. So the really cool thing about that is all of my students connect to me on social media, and they're all connected. Like, I'm excited to have, hundreds of followers. They have thousands of followers. So by connecting to them, you connect to a much, much huger, broader audience, because they share, posts that I make. So I've been really, really busy in the digital space getting prepared for the launch. And then the last two things that were, like, we had two physical signings that were set up that have been canceled. But one of them, Indigo, the big book chain here in Canada, they're going to convert it to a virtual session like this, a Zoom type session, a webinar. And then I just set up an arrangement to do a virtual book launch with Murder by the Book in Houston, Texas. So they're an independent bookstore, which is great. And they are really into the digital space as well. They've been doing Facebook Live events. And so they're going to do one for Broken Genius.
That is awesome.
I just wanted to, as a counterpoint to the digital and moving away from in-store, I just know personally from my book sales, the places I've touched physically, those are where I sell the most books. And obviously that grows, that, you know, from in-store appearances, then it grows to online from maybe people meeting you there. But I don't think that's completely dead, although right now it's completely dead. But personally, it's made a huge difference for me going to places and having that little cloud move outward.
It's certainly something I'd like to do. You know, being my debut book and first novel, you want to sit there and sign books for people. You want to have that face-to-face connection. But, you know, COVID-19, what are you going to do?
What are you going to do? All right, so I think this is really interesting. Since this is your first book, and we have just like thousands of books and millions of years worth of experience on the panel, I want to know from everybody, and I'm going to start with Doug this time, but I want to know, what is the one piece of writing advice that you wish you had gotten earlier in your career?
Trust your instincts. Tell the story the way you want to tell it. Again, we talk about voice all the time, and the single most important thing I think in storytelling is the voice of the storyteller or the character. That comes with, you know, reading and writing and experience, and then confidence. Trust your instincts that you know what you're doing. You might not, but you got to get it out your way. And I wish I'd learned that way, way, way early. I never would have outlined a book in my life had I known that. I'd have just started writing like I do now.
That's awesome. Joe, what about you?
This is going to sound terribly cynical and callous, but nobody cares. They really don't. So the trick is you got to get them to care. You got to find a way around that, because, you know, you think if you write a book and it's, you know, it's so precious to you and it means so much to you, and then it just means here's your book with all these other people. Everybody has a book. That guy has a book. He has a book. He has a book. He has a book. Guy across the street has a book. So you have to find a way to make your book stand out. And it goes so much further than just the writing. Being able to write means you're invited to the party. You know, selling the books and finding a way to get your word out there and have somebody see you is a totally separate skill set. And it's something you just learn and have to navigate, and marketing and branding and all that, all those words we hate are just as important as the writing itself.
Awesome. Matt, what say you?
Well, I wish someone had told me a long time ago when I was very young to do something with your life, so you've had some life experiences to draw upon, but I threw that up. I would say what I wish people had told me is I'm glad they didn't, is that it's, or that I know now rather, is that it's really hard and it takes a long time. And I think I would have written anyway, but if I would have known it took me so long to get published, maybe I would have given a second thought. Also, I wish I would have known that it's important to have a wife beater shirt when you're typing, so it helps you
faster. I've not worn pants in 57 days. I'm not putting
wear pants.
Well, I mean, there's not in my house today. What next?
Vincent, what piece of writing advice would you give?
About 20 years ago, when I published my first book with Delacorte, my editor was like, "Oh, like, take a break now, slow down." Bad advice, really bad advice, because I found I could write a novel in a month. And, you know, I'm like Joe, I have enough material right now, like, to last me 3 years, right? So I could have, I slowed down and I partied like a rock star and that whole bit, because I was very young and all that. But write and read as much as possible. Don't ever let anybody tell you to slow down. Put out the product while it's fresh, while you got it in your head, because kind of like Joe said, like, nobody really cares. But if you keep yourself relevant, if you keep putting out product, you know, if you keep jabbing, you're gonna score.
Great. Don't take a break.
Don't take a break.
And last, Mary, what advice would you give to Drew?
Well, it's twofold, and a lot of it echoes Joe. First of all, keep writing. Don't give up, because if you're a writer and you don't write, it'll turn it in your insides into a mental illness and you won't be doing well. So keep writing. But secondly, it's a business. It's not just creation. It's not just art. It's a business. and you've got to be able to change hats and turn into that marketer, which some of us have more skill at than others. But I really appreciated hearing other people's ways of handling building an image and branding themselves and building community. So, you know, I enjoyed listening to you guys. Thanks for sharing with
me. Thanks to all of you. You guys have been absolutely fantastic. Good luck with all of your books, because I know you guys have new stuff coming out, and you can see all of the book covers right on screen. And of course, there will be information right down below. So thanks so much for being here, everybody.
Thank you.
Thanks, Lisa.
Thanks, Lisa.
Thanks.
Bye, guys. And Drew, welcome to the team. Nobody cares.
It's you.
Hello, yes. Mary.
Thanks for that.